So we've already increased by 2 degrees.
2 degrees increase in the global temperature is significant when compared to the temperature range suitable for our living. Is the trend same across the globe, or does it vary from city to city? Let's find out the trend in the climate change for the city of Toronto. We are going to use Matplotlib to customize visuals and create animations. Afterwards, we are going to use Seaborn to create exploratory charts like heat map and path plots. Then we will create a set of 4 commonly used statistical charts. Let's open the Spider ID. We are going to use the 20th century Toronto climate dataset, the same one that we have used in the NumPy tutorial. Let's import the required libraries. Create a data frame DF month to read the Toronto climate CSV file. Run it. Let's observe the dataset. It has monthly mean and extreme temperatures and monthly snowfall and rainfall starting from the year 1901 to 2000. Remember how the Tesla presentation showed the yearly variations of the mean temperature? Let's group the data by year and calculate the mean of monthly temperatures, maximum and minimum of extreme temperatures, and the sum of total snowfall and rainfall, and name it as DF underscore year data frame. Run the selected block. 1200 monthly rows are now reduced to 100 yearly rows, and the fields are aggregated as specified. Let's do one more thing before plotting. In order to compare apples to apples, let's convert the temperature from Celsius to Fahrenheit as shown in the Tesla presentation. A new column is added now. Reset the index to bring back the year as a column field. This will be helpful when we run the exploratory charts later. We are all set now to create visuals. The figure is the foundation for plotting in Matplotlib. In this case, one axis object is created in a figure of size 14 by 10. Let's start with the line plot, selecting all rows, keeping the column index of 0, the year column as x-axis, and the column index of 6, the mean temperature in Fahrenheit, as the y-axis. The show command is added to display the figure. Run it. The basic plot is ready. Let's customize it by adding a background image to the axis. In this case, a Toronto skyline as a background, since the dataset is Toronto related. IF show displays data as an image, and the aspect auto means that the image would fit within the limit of the axis. Run the selection. We see a line plot over the image. Let's change the color to make the line easier to see. Color of white, and let's increase the line width as well. Nice. One of the advantages of Matplotlib is the customization of visuals. Let's bring in the tick labels inside the image to make the plot look like the presented one. Move the x-axis ticks from the label inwards by 30 and change the color and size. Likewise for the y-axis. Also, let's add labels and titles. Customize location as needed. Run it. The plot now looks very close to one that Elon Musk presented. The key difference is that he had the global data and our dataset is only for the city of Toronto until the year 2000. Just a minor declutter here. Let's extend the image a little bit to avoid the overlap of the line graph and the tick label. Add grid. Run again. Now the static plot. Let's answer the question we started with. Is the trend same across the globe, or does it vary? Looking at the average of the first few years and the last few years, the temperature in Toronto has increased from 45 to 49 degrees, a 4-degree increase, which is almost double that of the global temperature increase. Clearly, the temperature increase is not uniform globally. It depends on where you live. Next, we'll add animation. The plot function typically returns a list of line 2D objects. We need a line object to create an animation. Let's assign a new variable line and add a comma to get the first element of the list. For the range 0 to 100, Funk animation uses the figure as the base. Animate is a user-defined function. We'll come back to that soon. Delays 60 milliseconds between frames and saves 100 frames to cache. The animate user-defined function creates a series of images with the increasing number of row data and returns the line object to every loop. Save the animation as zip file. Open the file tab and remove the grid line. I see it as a clutter. Run. Now a file move.gif is added to the folder. Open it. Let's run it side by side. Wow. This supports why we need to move faster to the sustainable transportation. Next one is exploratory data analysis. The correlation matrix is the output from using a pandas function. The matrix depends on the correlation between all the possible pairs of the values in the data set. Create a heat map using the correlation matrix data. Axe1 is the axis object with the annotation in it, and it uses the blues color map. Let's run the selected block. The correlation values can fall between -1 and +1. 1 means 100% correlation. Year-to-year cell or any cell in the diagonal is 100% correlated. We also see 1 here because the temperature in Fahrenheit is calculated from Celsius. There is a perfect correlation here. 0.59 is a moderate correlation. Positive 0.59 means increasing trend. As air increases, so does the monthly mean temperature. Let's create a pair plot to visualize the same information in charts. The diagonal cells are histogram displaying the count of the values. We know that a positive sign in the heat map means increasing trend. How about the value 0.59? It tells us about the dispersion of the data along the trend line. The correlation of 1 between the temperature in Celsius and the Fahrenheit means no dispersion at all. Now, let's add a 4-pack statistical plot. 2x2 with the super title, Snowfall Trends in Toronto, mainly focusing on the total snowfall and the monthly mean temperature. Any monthly snowfall less than 2 cm are likely flurries and it would disappear quickly. So let's disregard them. Let's filter the months that have more than 2 cm in snowfall and assign to a new data frame, df_snow. Let's add a histogram to the axis 0, 0, first row and first column to determine the snowfall frequency based on the monthly mean temperature. Splitting the range by 9 bins and KD, kernel density estimation of true, smoothens the histogram and plots a curve. Run it. Snowfall mostly occurred when the temperature is around -3 to -4°C. Let's add a scatter plot at axis 0, 1 to show the relationship between the amount of snowfall and the mean temperature using df_snow as the data. Color blue and 0.8 transparency. 0 means fully transparent and 1 means opaque. Run it. The takeaway here is that most of the snowfall occurred between 0 and -5°C. The good thing is there is no snowfall when the monthly mean temperature goes below -10°C. However, an outlier is noticed. A snowfall occurred when the temperature is around -12°C, and another outlier is the 120 cm monthly snowfall. Let's add a text outlier at those two locations and attach it to the axis 0, 1. Run. The next visual is a horizontal bar plot. Attach it to axis 1, 0, that's second row and first column. The chart is going to display the monthly mean snowfall. We see mean snowfall is around 38 cm in January and close to 30 cm in December. Let's replace the month number with the month name to make it easier to read. The horizontal line represents 95% confidence interval. Finally, another important statistical plot. A box plot to visualize the complete distributions of the snowfall, this time using the master data frame df_month. This will display data from all months, including the months that had less than 2 cm snowfall. Set the tick labels with all 12 months. We see a median snowfall of around 37 cm in January, and the whiskers show the range of distributions. One of the outliers, 120 cm snowfall, occurred in January. In summary, Matplotlib helps to customize plots while Seaborn helps to explore the dataset and create statistical plots quickly. It's not about Matplotlib versus Seaborn. It is about using them together to create awesome visuals. A link to download the dataset and the code is available in the description. Enjoy coding. Learning is fun!